I'm going to show you my personal top 7 powerful Illustrator tools and why I do feel they are the top 7 for your graphic design workflow. You might have seen tutorials and videos on some of these tools, but I wanted to collect the top 7 most powerful tools in one video, so every designer and person who's interested can make use of them in one video. So the first function that I think is really, really powerful and something you should be using in Illustrator is actually the Artboards panel. Illustrator is awesome because we can actually make many different artboards on one document. You actually have the artboard tool here, which allows you to change the name, the size, and also the position of the artboard. Also, you can actually hold down the Alt Option key, drag and duplicate the artboards like so. That's all well and good, but there is actually something else completely dedicated to the artboards that I want to show you. And that is the artboard panel, which is located in the top drop-down menu. So in this panel, you can see the various different artboards that we have, and you can toggle between them quite easily. Also, you can change the order of the artboards here. With a specific artboard selected, you can come into the artboard options, which is a very handy thing to be using. You can precisely change the size of an artboard, as well as the name, the orientation, and you actually have some presets here, which is very, very handy. Also, one very handy setting is the Show Center Mark, because I'm always trying to find the center of my artboard, and this will present a green marker showing you exactly where it is. So with the current artboard selected, if we create a new artboard in the panel here, it's going to duplicate the settings and the format of that artboard. We can also click and drag to move around the orientation of the artboards in the panel. And when we click on a specific artboard, Illustrator will zoom to the artboard automatically. Also, if you want to remove empty and useless artboards, you can use this option here, which will quickly remove any unwanted artboards. Also, in the artboard panel, we can quickly change the name of an artboard by just double-clicking the box here and then typing in the new name for the artboard. It's best to keep things organized in Adobe Illustrator, especially if you're working with many different artboards and you want to export or print specific ones. But yeah, the artboard panel is, I think it's overlooked by many designers, but it is very powerful, especially when you're working on large documents with many different artboards going on. So moving on to the second powerful tool in Adobe Illustrator, we're going to be looking at a function that can export files for web, such as PNG and JPEG, but we can actually export specific artboards as separate files, which is really powerful, and I'm going to show you how to do that right now. So we're working on one document and I've got 3 different artboards with 3 different designs. If we come up to Window and then Assets Export, we're going to be met with this window here. Now you want to make sure you can see the export settings, and I'm going to remove all of these presets and just set up my own one. I'm actually going to export PNGs for my designs here. Then it's just a case of dragging and dropping your design elements into this panel. You want to make sure that you've got all of the assets clicked by holding down Shift and clicking every single aspect of this panel. You also have an iOS and Android option, but I'm not going to mess with that today. You then just export your files and Illustrator will send them to a folder on your desktop. So now I've actually got 3 different, well actually I've got 4 because I had one in here before. I've got 4 different files just from one document. This saves a lot of time and it's very, very powerful indeed. Now thirdly, another process or function that is really overlooked in my opinion is the appearance panel. It's hugely powerful because you can add so many effects and do so many different things just from this one panel and on one vector shape. So for example here I've got a circle, and let's go ahead and open up the appearance panel in the top drop down menu. So as you can see, I've got a fill with no stroke, and we can easily add a stroke right here. Now I can actually bring the stroke below the fill layer, which is something you cannot do with strokes normally. You can only do that within the appearance panel. I'm going to quickly adjust the stroke weight. And then I'm going to duplicate this stroke by heading into the fly down menu. I can add multiple strokes to one shape, and I can adjust their weights and their colors really, really easily with this appearance panel. So just like that, I've got two different strokes on one shape. Make sure you've got your shape selected when you make adjustments, because as you can see here, I'm changing the stroke to 100 points and it didn't actually appear on the shape because it wasn't selected. So what else can we do from the appearance panel? Well, firstly, we can add effects such as Gaussian blurs and so forth. Make sure to keep the preview box checked while you're working on the blur effect. And yeah, the blur is not looking that great, but we can adjust that in the document raster effect settings. But going back to the appearance panel, I can then adjust where this blur stroke layer is in relation to the shape itself by offsetting the path. The offset box is going to dictate how far away from the shape things are offset. So 40 isn't that too far away from the shape, but let's try something like 300. And as you can see, I've got a huge ring around my shape that is offset. And again, this is just in one vector shape, all in the appearance panel. You can see how powerful this will be. And just to prove it is on one vector shape, let's enter into outline mode. And as you can see, it's just one circle. So the fourth most powerful tool in Illustrator that you need to be using is the Pathfinder tool. I do actually have a dedicated video to this, which I'm going to link down below. But briefly to go over things, the Pathfinder allows you to create designs and complex shapes by cutting and intersecting various different objects into each other. Now this saves you a lot of time as a designer, as opposed to say drawing things with the pen tool for yourself. And as I've said before, if you hold down the Alt or the Option key when using the top row options here, you can make compound paths. This means that even if you've cut out the design, you can still take the group selection tool and then change and edit the layout of the pathfind operation, as opposed to your shapes being cut in a fixed position in a certain way. But yeah, I do have a dedicated video to the Pathfinder, which I'm going to link down below. Another really useful option in the Pathfinder is to use a divide function. This is going to cut out the entire selection along the vector paths, which means when you ungroup the selection, you have full control over what you want to remove and what you want to edit. The Pathfinder is truly helpful and also powerful for making quick and complex shapes. Similar to the Pathfinder, we next have the Shape Builder tool. You can find this here in the toolbar, but before you go and use it, you must select your objects and then take the Shape Builder tool. Now with this one, you can hold down the Alt or the Option key to bring up the minus icon over your cursor, and then wherever you draw, you're going to erase that specific selection. If you do let go of the Alt or the Option key, then you start to unite shapes together as one wherever you draw. This is very, very powerful, and it's similar to the Pathfinder tool, but I feel with this one, you have more control and freedom whilst using the tool itself. You can quickly come up with complex and intricate shapes by using both the Pathfinder and the Shape Builder, as they are both very powerful indeed. So, the penultimate function that is very powerful in Adobe Illustrator is the Layers window. And again, I think many designers overlook this in Adobe Illustrator. They think it's just for Photoshop, but that's not actually true. The layers panel in Illustrator is very, very important in keeping your work neat, tidy, and organized. So as you can see, I've got my layers labeled apart from one of the circles. So to add a name or a label, just double click it and type it in. And like I said, I can pick any of these shapes by name, click here, and I will automatically select them. This is very, very handy on large, complicated, busy designs. I think you should be labeling your work and organizing layers, especially on larger projects. It's just more professional and it makes your workflow that much better. You can also hide layers and arrange them and do all sorts of things from the layers panel. Also, when you group things together with Command or Control G, you can see the group being created in the layers window, which is really, really awesome, and it helps when you're working with many groups and many layers. Of course, you can also label and rename your groups as well. So finally today, the function in Adobe Illustrator that is very, very powerful and something you should be using is the Blend tool. Now firstly, we can use the Blend tool to make interesting patterns and shapes and designs, and you can actually access it here, or you can just press W on your keyboard. Clicking while holding down Shift between shapes will blend them together like so, and that is really neat, and that's a really cool thing to be able to do. But the Blend tool is also good for making copies of shapes over a set distance or even a certain amount of shapes. So to let me demonstrate, let's take this circle here and duplicate it over and then use the Blend tool again. We can actually hold down the Alt or the Option key and then click the Blend itself, and this will bring up the Blend options. If we choose specified steps, we can actually choose how many copies of the shape we want to make. Now this is very quick and it's a very powerful technique to keep in mind, and the Blend tool can have many applications within your workflow. So there are my personal top 7 powerful tools and functions in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you found today's video useful, and do let me know if you agree with my selection of 7 different tools. Also, do let me know what you want to see on this channel, because I am focusing on making only 2 or 3 videos per week, but actually making the quality and the length longer, as opposed to putting out 4 or 5 shorter, more rushed videos. Do subscribe to my channel if you haven't done already for weekly graphic design content, so that you can boost your skills and your awareness as a graphic designer. Don't forget to like and share my content on social media, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.